Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and the visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's God Talk. Some people talk to God and others believe that God talks to them. Join us in conversation with authors, religious clergy, metaphysicians, and regular people like you and I and God Talk. God Talk is a podcast available on FM radio, Roku TV, and online. Subscribe at valderbeebeshow.com. You can also subscribe at youtube.com/valderbeebeshow. Join the conversation of God Talk. I'll see you there.
Good day and welcome back to the Valder Beebe Show as I start my day with my first guest. My first guest is Emily Brandwin. She's a safety expert and I like this. She's a former CIA agent. She wants to talk about National Preparedness Month. Emily, welcome to the Valder Beebe Show for the first time.
Hey, thank you so much. Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
Well, I love those titles because I can't think of anyone to give us solid and real information because September is National Preparedness Month. So let's talk about why is it so important to be prepared when dealing with natural emergencies?
Well, you know, when I worked at the CIA, the most important thing they taught us was to be prepared for the expected, the unexpected, and everything in between. Because if you're prepared when disaster hits, you'll know exactly what to do and you don't have to even think about it. You know, and I think we've had a real challenging 2020, especially with weather. We had 30 named storms, 13 hurricanes, 12 of them actually hit land. We had tornadoes and fires and floods. And so it's so important to really be prepared because 2021, 2022, it's going to be very similar to 2020.
That's incredible. Now, we did our own little survey last week, and people used to prepare for, like, if there was a fire, how to get out safely, those kind of things. And they aren't even preparing for that, Emily. We found out a large portion of people have not practiced a family fire drill. So how can we get them to be prepared for a national disaster?
Well, the first thing you need to think about is power, because it's the first thing that you usually lose during a natural disaster. So think about, you need to keep the lights on. What can you do? And the EcoFlow's Delta Portable Power Station, it provides power anywhere, anytime you need it. It's solar powered, and so you can simultaneously charge up to 13 devices, and not just devices, but also home appliances, and you can do all this. You can recharge them from 0 to 80% in an hour when being recharged. So you can have peace of mind that you'll have power if all the power goes away, which is so important because I think that's the first thing that we think about when there's a storm. You know, the lights have gone out, our refrigerator is gone, you know, is turned off, our phones, we need to be connected. And so the portable power station really helps you do that and gives you that peace of mind and that confidence.
That's really good information. So what are some of the other things we can consider as we make an emergency plan? Because I believe we have to have a plan.
You have to have a plan and you want to make sure you do it. The most important thing also is to think about those things that are really irreplaceable. And for most of us, it's those photos. And so with Epson's Fast Photo FF680W wireless scanner, you can stay ahead of a natural disaster and you can, you know, scan all of those photos. You can scan thousands of photos and which is amazing. You can do a photo, scan a photo every second, and you can scan the front and the back of the photo, which is really important to keep those memories. You can also scan important documents so you can keep them out of harm's way. So think about it. If it's, you know, life insurance policies, if it's your car title, your driver's license, all those documents that if they got into harm's way, you can keep them safe and secure and make sure that your family is really taken care of in that way as well. And it tackles really that daunting task of making sure all those documents are just organized in one safe, secure place, making sure that you and your family are really prepared if something should happen.
I had never thought of the photos, Emily. You're so on track.
Yeah, okay, you need to keep those because that would be just tragic if those disappear.
Well, it's your life. It's really your life in pictures. I love that. Okay, if you could give us one safety tip as you leave, what do you want us to know about being prepared?
The one thing about being prepared is if you're prepared when disaster hits, you won't have to worry. And also get a first aid kit. I know it sounds super old school, but make sure you have it because that's what you need in terms of first aid if anything should happen, and make sure it's up to date and current. Every 4 to 6 months, just take stock of it and make sure it's well replenished. If you have medicine there, make sure it's not expired because it won't do anything for you. So just make sure that you have it, you know where it is so you can always access it. God forbid if you need it.
Emily, I thank you so much. A place online for people to put all this together?
Sure, tipsontv.com. You can also visit me at CIA Spy Girl and say hi to me on Twitter as well.
All right, Emily Brandwin, thanks for being my guest and getting us prepared on the Valder Beebe Show.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.